Hi friends, I would like to talk today about a subject that has been bothering me quite a bit now that I'm just crossed 60 and the perspective on life is kind of changing. The priority more nowadays is to conserve what one has made and put it to a good investment portfolio or to have a sizable part of it safe and secure and available at call when you want money back. All this set me looking at various options that we have in terms of our financial assets and where do we keep them. For most people in our country, India I talk about, for most people the safest place to put our money has been in either the insurance, life insurance company deposits or bank deposits. Bank deposits, of course, are the most basic return yielding instruments, but the reason why most people put their money in bank deposits is obviously they trust the bank. And they trust that the bank will give that money whenever we want, without any questions and without any delays or whatsoever. So the bank deposit is one of the core assets that people who are in the senior citizen class are going to have. Besides banks, of course, there are insurance deposits and there are other things, but I'm talking about risk-free instruments now. But the more I have been reading of late about the size of the debts that are in the banking system, I am a very worried lot. I read in a book which has been written by a very authoritative person that almost all the major public sector banks of India, they have huge levels of non-performing assets. Non-performing assets means bad loans. People who have taken huge loans from these banks but have not repaid them. Now, obviously, there is a systemic correction which is there in the Reserve Bank's policies that banks have to be provisioning for their bad debts in order to be able to write them out and then recoup the capital that has gone into those bad debts. But many banks do not have adequate provisioning. So as a result, that money is only on paper and in reality it has evaporated. It has gone out of the system. And with the bank still showing it as loans but not payable, but then when you rewrite those assets, then the bank obviously has to pay it from its losses. Now, it's not very clear how these things are going to get resolved, but the expectation has been that because public sector banks are essentially controlled by government, so the government might bail them out or either through merging some of these bad banks with some of the better ones. But the bottom line is that good money that has gone into these banks from deposits like yours and mine is actually flying out of the system as bad loans. And that is a big, 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 big challenge. If a government tomorrow doesn't bail out a bank, or if the Reserve Bank says that the government has to actually put in that money or somebody has to put in that money in order to recover the losses, then we are in big trouble. The reason why this system has even happened, in my view, and it could be a very ignorant view, but it is a basic systemic deficiency in our banking act. Our deposits are the best source of money for the banks because the bank has to pay very low interest on our money. And when the bank lends it onwards, it pays, it gets a commercially remunerative return on its investment through which it makes profit and also increases its reserves and can pay us up when we want our money. And the banking system also depends on one assumption that everybody is not going to take their money at the same time. So the bank has enough money to give others without having the worry of returning all that money at very short notice. So the problem though, my friends, is that when you borrow from a bank, you are liable to pay the entire amount of money to the bank along with interest. But when the bank has borrowed money from you as a deposit, the bank is liable to pay you only 1 lakh rupees per account That was until a few years ago. And now, only up to 5 lakh rupees an account. So no matter how much money you have put into your bank, if the bank goes bust, the bank is liable to give you only a maximum of 5 lakh rupees per account. Now, this is actually a big loophole whereby the bank systemically has a low risk in its business model. If the bank were liable for every penny of its deposit, it would be far more diligent in making its loans. And this is something which the examples of Yes Bank, the examples of a few other banks this year are teaching us, that the banks have been extravagant in lending to the wrong people, but they have played with the money of common folks like you and me. I wonder why the bank should be liable for only such a small amount of money to you when your deposits with the bank are far bigger. What would be the reverse if you borrow a crore of rupees from a bank and if there was a system that you are only liable to pay 5 lakhs of rupees? Would that system be tenable? No. So basically, I would like to submit that our money, the money of common depositors, is at a huge risk, and this needs to be addressed by the system through regulation or through a court intervention. And I am thinking of filing a public interest litigation in this regard. Please let me know your views.